Today I am going to discuss about types of banks. So welcome to my YouTube channel Mechanical Engineering Management. So first of all, let's see the banking structure in the India. And in this structure you can see over here on the apex position there is a RBI, that means Reserve Bank of India, and that is the Central Bank of India. It has the highest authority, the banking structure, and so that sometimes it is called as the bankers of bank. So basically there are two types of the banks are under the RBI, scheduled banks and non-scheduled banks. Once again, scheduled banks is classified in two category, commercial banks and cooperative banks. Commercial banks are further classified in four different category: public sector bank, private sector banks, foreign banks, regional rural banks. Public sector banks are further classified as three different category: SBI and associate banks, nationalized banks and other public sector banks. Cooperative banks are further classified as state cooperative banks, direct cooperative banks and other cooperative banks. So in this session we are going to see all these types of the banks briefly, one by one. So let's start from the first, Reserve Bank of India. This is a symbol of the Reserve Bank of India. Reserve Bank of India is the central bank of our country. It was established on 1st April 1934 under the RBI Act of 1934. It holds the apex position in the banking structure as we have seen earlier. RBI performs various developmental and promotional functions. As of now, 26 public sector banks in India, out of which 21 nationalized banks and 5 are State Bank of India and its associate banks. There are total 92 commercial banks in India. Public sector banks hold near about 75% total bank deposits in India. So public sector banks hold nearly 75% of the total bank deposits in India. For example, Federal Reserve Bank is the central bank of USA. Bank of England is the central bank in UK. And Reserve Bank of India is the central bank in India. So central bank is known as bankers bank also. Now let's see the second one, scheduled bank. By definition, any bank which is listed in the second schedule of the Reserve Bank of India Act 1934 is considered as scheduled bank. So very simple, banks are listed in second schedule, then it is called as the scheduled bank. The list includes the State Bank of India and its subsidiaries like State Bank of Travancore, etc. And next, all nationalized banks like Bank of Baroda, Bank of India, etc. Next, private sector banks, regional rural banks, foreign banks like HSBC, Citibank, and some cooperative banks. So these all are called as the scheduled bank because of all are listed in the second schedule of Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. Now the next one, non-scheduled bank. Non-scheduled banks by definition are those which are not listed in the second schedule of the RBI Act 1934. So very simple, banks are listed in second schedule of RBI are called as scheduled bank. If they are not listed, then it is called as non-scheduled bank. Banks with a reserve capital of less than 5 lakh rupees qualify as non-scheduled bank. Unlike scheduled banks, they are not entitled to borrow from the RBI for normal banking purposes, except in emergency or abnormal circumstances. It is very simple, scheduled bank can borrow the money from the RBI, whereas non-scheduled bank can't borrow the money from the RBI, except in emergency case. Jammu and Kashmir Bank is an example of a non-scheduled commercial bank. Now it's turn of the commercial bank. Commercial banks are regulated under the Banking Regulation Act 1949 and their business model is designed to make profit. Their primary function is to accept deposit and grant loans to the general public, corporate and government. So name itself indicates commercial bank that is specially designed to make profit. And the primary function is to accept deposits and grant loans to the general public, corporate and government. The next one, cooperative banks. Cooperative bank was set up by passing a Cooperative Act in 1904. They are organized and managed on the principle of cooperation and mutual help. That's why it is called as cooperative bank. The main objective of cooperative bank is to provide a rural credit. Unlike commercial banks who are driven by profit, cooperative banks work on a no profit, no loss basis. So this is the main difference. Commercial banks having the main objective is to make profit, whereas cooperative banks work on no profit, no loss basis. And the main function of cooperative bank is to provide the credit to the rural area. Name of some cooperative banks in India are Andhra Pradesh State Cooperative Bank Limited, then Bihar State Cooperative Bank Limited, then Chhattisgarh Rajya Sahakari Bank Maryadit, then the Gujarat State Cooperative Bank Limited, Haryana Rajya Sahakari Bank Limited. So these are the examples of the cooperative banks in India. Now the next one is the public sector bank. And here you can see these are the example of the public sector banks. When government own the majority of share capital of a banking company, then it is known as public sector bank. So very simple, in public sector bank, the majority of the share capital is by government. Example of public sector banks are SBI, that means State Bank of India, then PNB means Punjab National Bank, Canara Bank, Bank of Baroda, Allahabad Bank, etc. Currently, there are 21 nationalized banks in India. State Bank of India is the largest commercial bank in terms of volume of all commercial banks. Now, private sector bank. Keep in mind that these all banks having main objective is to make profit. So these are the examples of the private sector bank. When private individuals own the majority, more than 52% of the share capital of a banking company, then it is known as private sector bank. So in case of the public sector bank, the majority of the holding is by the government, whereas in case of private sector bank, the majority holding is by the individual. And that's why these are known as the private sector bank. Example of a private banks are HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank, Axis Bank, Kotak Mahindra Bank, Federal Bank, etc. Now the next one, foreign banks. Foreign banks are international banks which are set up or registered in foreign countries and are obligated to follow regulation of both its home as well as host country. Loan limits for these banks are based on the capital of the parent bank, thus allowing foreign banks to provide more loans than other subsidiary banks. Foreign banks are those banks which have their head office abroad, like Citibank, HSBC, Standard Chartered, etc. are the examples of the foreign banks in India. Now next one is the regional rural banks. These are also scheduled commercial banks, but they are established with the main objective of providing credit to weaker sections of the society, like agricultural laborers, marginal farmers, and small enterprises. Other important function carried out by RRBs include providing banking and financial services to rural and semi-urban area. Next, government operations like disbursement of wages of MGNREGA workers, distribution of pensions, etc. Next, NABARD, that means National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, holds the apex position in the agriculture and rural development. If you want to see more videos, then subscribe my YouTube channel and go to playlist. Thanks, my dear friends, for watching this video.